The aim of getting a panel like this is to trigger the thinking in the minds of the young people. And I'm very sure after this last 50 minutes, each one of you who's sitting here has started thinking, what is this story? I shouldn't use the word story, you don't like it. What is this commodity called gold? Right? So that is the sole purpose. You have heard all the brilliant speakers. Very, very experienced. We are fortunate to have them here. We are running out of time. So what I'm going to do is, we'll take, say, two or three questions at a stretch. And then I'm going to request the panelists to try to answer them. You can direct your question by name to the panelists. And then we'll request that panelist to answer, or you can have a general question. We'll spend about 5 minutes on this. And then I want to go for the closing round. With the panelists, asking them a simple question. So let's start. What are the questions? Okay.
Then what's the logic behind why central banks are holding gold? Because it looks like there is a lot of buying up a lot of gold in these markets as part of the reserve. So what's the logic there?
I have a question for Mr. Bhaskar. You were just saying that the domestic manufacturing of gold should be improved, and you just stopped. So I just wanted to know what kind of impact does it have on our economy as we boost the manufacturing, and we as you have these Tanishq and Gold Plus brands, you manufacture ornaments, and also what impact does it have on economy? How does it help economy?
Gold society, and you cannot just break in like that. It cannot be broken. I think the last speech was that we can just transform the society. It's just talking that in India you can apply Keynesian economics anytime where we need a structural model.
Last estimated turnover of the jewelry industry is 250,000 crores in India, domestic. Now, in comparison, I'll just give you a rough and ready comparison. The entire watch industry is 5,000 crores, 7,000 crores. So it is several times bigger. It's next only to food. Now, I know only of our company. At 10,000 crores turnover in the jewelry business, we make 9% margin. Okay? So one is value add. We employ about 1,500 people across retail and manufacturing. So you're generating employment. Each of them earning, let's say, anywhere between 2 lakhs and 50 lakhs, let's say, in that entire business of ours. A 10,000 crore industry turnover, the VAT plus income taxes, etc., on 9%, if you take 25%, 33% income tax, etc., you can calculate. So the value add, and then you have to multiply that by, you know, scale it up to 250,000. The problem is, more than 50% of the industry is not above board. That is our problem. Which is, they don't really pay taxes, they don't really show their income, and there's a lot of black money getting. Now, I don't want to talk about what we do or the way we do it. The transformation that, you know, the RBI deputy governor sought is what we started as a journey, both in the consumer end as well as but first at the industry end, which is employing a karigar, making his life better, improving design, being transparent at this retail level. All that is value add in some way or the other for the economy. In that way, showcasing how jewelry industry can be run. And 10 years after we came in, the first IPO came into the jewelry industry, and now there are 4 or 5 companies which are you know, operating in the kind of business model in which we are operating. We're not saying it is right, but certainly it is transparent and it pays taxes and it adds value. So if we can transform the rest, not we, the country can transform the rest, there's a huge value addition, huge employment potential, and it's a global scale. Incidentally, there is no foreign player in India worth, I mean, not even 1% market share. Cartier, Bulgari, whoever you take. Indian women want Indian jewelry. Unlike watches, cars, refrigerators, televisions, even clothes. Indian women want Indian jewelry.
I have not seen any poor person has been able to get out of his gold is, at the most, it has been, he has borrowed the money and money lender has shallowed the gold and in the temple priest has taken that. Beyond that, it gold has not added any value. I don't know how many of you have sold the gold in the difficult point and could make your living. I can say, I know, at the most people have done, they have borrowed the money. Now, there are, and that's okay, but the gold has already gone. I am saying, had you kept the money in the bank, you would have been better off. That's what I am saying. You do that thing, that is a better value. That's the only point I am saying. That you, had you done that, but he is not doing. Look, what is happening, you don't understand. People, when the girl child is born, they are purchasing the gold coin, but don't change the girl child to the school. Now, you don't know what is his social implication. The problem is that. But I have no problem. All these things you do, provided you can afford to do that, you don't have money. We are not realizing that. All I understand that, but you don't have that money to purchase the gold. You are not realizing that. In your pocket there is money. You don't say that I can do this activity, but from where the money will come? You have a current account deficit. So unless you address that issue, it will not happen. This is the thing. Rest all we can debate, what we can do. I have no problem. 20,000 tons of gold is available in this country. You do manufacture, you give the security, whatever you want to do. People say gold deposit. Because gold is so attraction, nobody wants to melt their own jewelry. Now, when you go for gold to give to the bank, he will say you melt the jewelry. Now, if you melt the jewelry, nobody wants to do that. And that's why it does not pick up. That's a problem. There are many, you see, this is our entire thinking in the society. That's what I want. Why I have come here. We have to think on that, research on that, listen to everybody, and can we prepare a business model where you can convert this thing? That's the purpose. We have to do that. There is no other way. There is, you see, I have no pleasure to tell him that, look, you can't do that thing. That is not the issue. Issue is that country as a whole, we cannot afford to do that. That's the point only I'm saying. Within that, we have to find out a solution. You see, you bought, if you have money enough, you bought the gold. I'm not saying that. If you are rich, you bought the gold. Don't intoxicate the poor people. You see, look, why you say that illicit liquor is to be stopped, but you don't stop the illicit in the five-star hotel liquor? I say, look, that, let us not say that. It is poor, is that. You come, let us not come. Those who can manage the risk, those who understand this thing, those will the business, that is central bank, do it for a variety of reasons, because this is a proxy to the foreign currency. So we do that, that is also a part of our reserve, not the entire thing, but the poor person, whatever his entire income, he puts in the gold. We must understand the difference between the two. I am not prohibiting you, you should not go and purchase the gold. Only thing what I am saying, we don't allow the gold to be purchased from outside. Whatever is available inside, you do whatever you want to do. We are not private. If you can manufacture the gold from inside the India, please do that. We have no problem. And why you are saying, if you don't do, when I was born, $1 is equal to 5 rupees. It has become 50 rupees, and you blame the Reserve Bank of India is not doing anything. Now, if you are ready that $1 is equivalent to 500 rupees, all these people say gold has given this return. It is because currency has depreciated. In fact, Dr. Charan Singh, gold has given a negative return this year, internationally. And all of you are saying that what you are saying it is giving a negative return, gold has given a negative return. And that is why it is not an investment, it is a speculation. Sometime it will give higher return, sometime it will give lower return. In our case, we are not seeing it because our currency has depreciated by 50%. So I have no problem, then don't say that. You say that, okay, oil, if we are importing oil at $100 a barrel, we are ready to, $100 means 60,000 rupees, we are ready to spend 200,000 rupees, I have no problem. But, ladies and gentlemen, we cannot afford to do that. We must understand, it is beyond your capacity. If it is beyond your capacity, you cannot do that. That's the only point. It is a compulsion. So what Reserve Bank will do, you tell me. If you have any better thing, I have no problem in that. Okay. Now what is the second question?
I think Venki's question has partly been answered. Why did the Reserve Bank buy gold if gold was such a bad commodity? I think that was his question.
See,
that's been answered.
Very small, insignificant component, and believe me, I don't want to discuss whether that is a very rational decision, irrational decision. Let us leave it that. We do many things which is not rational. Look into that. Man, let us not go into that. There are many other issues. That does not mean, look, whatever I am saying, it is not Reserve Bank view. In the Reserve Bank, many people don't agree to my view. But I have got a panel discussion. You must debate. That is my view. It is not always Reserve Bank's view. What is Reserve Bank views? What the circular is issued, what governor says, that is the Reserve Bank view. But you are having a discussion, debate on the goal. Yes, I have been instrumental. I have been saying that we need to look into this aspect. Otherwise, you will be not able to do that. Some of these measures have been taken. But that does not mean I entirely agree. My view is that measures should have been much more stringent. But that's a different issue. What all we are saying, we are bringing the debate to the forum, that this is the issue, what are the issues, these gentlemen are saying something, we are saying, look, these are the considerations. That's the only point what I am trying to say that. Look, I am not saying I am right. And nor I am trying to say Mr. Bhatt is wrong. What I am saying, look, our line of argument is this, these are the issues, and I entirely agree, some of these is the issues we need to address, and I have absolutely no doubt our lifestyle about the gold has to undergo a change. What was our lifestyle about the gold before 2000 years when we were the richest nation in the world? We cannot say we becoming one of the poorest nations in the world. We look at the gold in the same way. If you try to do that, such contradiction will always come up. It will come to surface and on which we'll have no solution.
Just allow me to explain that to you. You know, the RBI recently launched inflation index bonds for the retail investor. And I think it was launched on December 22nd. The last date was December 31st. And it has now been extended to March 31st. And from what my journalist friends tell me, nobody is buying these bonds. And the reason for this is very, very simple. You know, the moment you walk into a bank these days, the first thing they want you to buy is an insurance policy. And these are investment-oriented insurance policies which pay a very, very high commission. Now, commission on these policies have been coming down over the years, but they're still higher than, you know, what every other financial product has to offer. And the reason for that is very, very simple. The reason for that is the fact that the government of India runs a very, very high fiscal deficit, which has to be financed. And, you know, the firm which finances this fiscal deficit to a very large extent is the Life Insurance Corporation of India. And if LIC does not offer high commissions on to its insurance agents, I mean, believe me, nobody is, you know, going to buy those policies which give 3 to 4% return every year. So the fact is, you know, if the government of India stops running a high fiscal deficit, we won't have a high inflation, and as a result, people will not buy as much gold as they have in the recent past. So the RBI cannot really do anything about it. It is the government of India which has to clamp down on all the money that it's been spending. Especially in the last 5 years where the fiscal deficit has gone up from 2.6% of the GDP to almost 5%.
I want to thank all the panelists who have been here. I want to thank each of the participants who have come and come here. I'm sure you have learned a lot. One thing which I have learned is the country is under a constraint. There are reasons why the Reserve Bank does what it does. There are reasons why the market participants have their own concerns in their own rights. Each one of them is right. We are a democratic country, and here we have seen very, very diversified views. My own view has been India is really five countries in one country. You have the super rich, you have the rich, you have the poor, you have the super poor. The super rich could be probably buying gold, middle income buys gold, the poorest doesn't. So there are one single model probably doesn't run across the country. But as a central bank, you have to have a monetary policy which is cutting across the country, and therefore it's important to take some measures. I think from today's discussion, we are all more better informed of what each one of the players in the market is thinking. So thanks once again. I would request our director in charge, Professor Devna Tirupati, to come and give, as a token of our thanks and gratitude to each of the participants, our memento. Professor.